103 The ATL's number one fit popping R&B. Big Tick, happy Monday. What it is, what it do, what it is, ATL. Tune in, turn up, and watch V103.com. Why? Because my sister from another mister's in the building. Hey, T-Bob.
Hey. I'm home. I'm so excited.
Are you excited?
Yes, I am.
How you been?
I've been good. I'm blessed.
I mean, because if you look at the news, like, you, something's always challenging you these days.
First of all, second of all, and third of all.
Yes, ma'am.
Jesus.
So let me start.
We're going to talk about that. Go say
about all of it. We're going to get the sad stuff first. So, okay, the European tour apparently was postponed because you suffered a neck injury.
I did, a neck and back injury, yeah.
Okay.
My fifth and sixth vertebrae, I have permanent damage, and I have to work on it.
Okay.
But it happened before I went on the American tour, and at that time, I couldn't walk.
Really?
So when they put it out, and I'm thinking they're just going to tell the promoters and the people who, you know, pay us.
Right.
And it didn't have to get out into the public. So they waited all the way until after we finished our American tour.
Right.
And I didn't just cancel it, which I could have.
Right.
I postponed it and said, just let me work on, because it got worse when I went on tour.
Right.
I worked on it before, and I went on tour anyway, and it got messed up a little bit again. So I've been in rehab and all that, and then I'm going to continue to work on it, and then I'll go overseas in, you know, Europe. Yeah, the beginning of the year.
So you're okay for the most part. You just need to, you know, take care of yourself.
Yes, some wear and tear, so, you know. Good way to put it. All this dancing over the years got a little bit of wear and tear, you know what I'm saying? So do a little rehab and some, put some tussin on it.
Put some tussin on it.
And then I'll be dancing again. I could still get it, though. Hey, I did mine for the D challenge and everything.
I'm scared.
I did.
I am so scared.
I did go to my page. I'm telling you, I did two of them.
I'm so scared. I'm going to listen to that momentarily. And then we were all sad to hear about what happened to your cousin.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Where is that right now, and where is it going right now?
My cousin, her name is Anita Johnson. That was her son. And they're suing the Peoria Police Department, but right. They're still not answering a lot of stuff. And she said some more stuff came out that wasn't good, and I'm going to talk to her today
okay. Because
I'm still trying to spread the word and get it out. But no matter how you put it or what you do, that was Daryl.
Yeah.
I haven't seen Daryl forever. Sorry, y'all. No matter how you put it and what you do, 18 times is excessive.
Right.
The punishment didn't fit the crime at all.
Mm.
He didn't hold anybody hostage. Threatened to kill anybody or kill anybody.
Right.
He was more harm to himself than anything.
Right.
And they used my cousin to tell him, son, it's safe. They was like, if you tell him to come out, we promise we'll give him the help he needs.
Right.
And they didn't wait for human resources to show up. Because, you know, mentally ill patients, they have certain people who talk to them.
Right.
They didn't wait, and they had his mother. And any child who hears their mother say, it's safe, baby, come out.
They believe it's safe.
They believe it's safe, and then came out. And they murdered my cousin. They had AR-15s. We go to war with those. Like,
right. Why? Well, I'm very sorry to hear about that.
Thank you.
I saw it come across. I was like, wow, she's just having a couple weeks going on around here.
Oh, so, when they said I couldn't walk.
Yeah, you couldn't walk. You was crippled and decrepit, and you couldn't booty shake no more.
I was like, they got me decrepit. People was cussing me out. I'm like, whoa, whoa, whoa.
Well, what I find interesting is you are a definite display of how real life happens to people who are celebrities.
Absolutely.
And lots of people don't get that.
No, they don't.
They just think it's all fun and turn up and money and fun and turn up.
Yeah, they really don't. And I don't turn up and I don't drink and I ain't turning up like that. Right?
Right.
So really, I work and my job is kids at home. Like when I'm off kids, and that's not necessarily off when you have a toddler
right. And
a soon to be 17 year old.
Right.
Teenagers are emotional. I got the two T's, toddler and teen. Like my teen is so emotional. And then my toddler, he's terrible too. I get no breaks.
Yeah, that's what's up. Well, T-Boz is here. We're going to talk about this new book that she has. We're going to talk about, she got new artists and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to talk about TLC and stuff. So we got all of that. Watch V103.com. You can text me questions or tweet me questions at Big Ticket Show. If you want to text a question, 404-741-WVEE. T-Boz live in studio with your man Big Tig on the People Station V103. Hey, People Station V103, the ATL's number one fit popping R&B. Big Tig, Big Things. Inviting the entire planet to tune in and turn up at watch V103.com as I take a gander at this one. Wonderful, wonderful literary piece of work here. A Sick Life written by Tion T-Boz Watkins, TLC and me. Stories from on and off the stage.
Yep.
So this is everything we wanted to know, but we ain't get to know?
Yeah, it's a lot in there. It's a lot.
What are some of the things that you cover in here? I know these answers. I just have to
I talk anywhere from being teased in school. I don't care if you have cancer, lupus, AIDS, sickle cell. If you've been sick, we can all relate on one accord. Mm. Having something foreign in our body that we don't understand, and the emotional, physical, and mental stuff you go through while you're sick. Divorce, single mother, like I don't care how much money you have, being a mom is no joke. Mm-hmm. And there's no rule book. So it's basically about a girl who wants something so bad and she's told she can't have it. And my sickle cell tried to stop me every step of the way, and other obstacles in my life and stuff about TLC that connect some of the dots and stories behind the scenes that you never got to understand. So the good, the bad, and the ugly is in that book. About me too. You know, I tell my bad as well.
Tell me some of the bad before I get to this.
Well, I put one of the worst fights in there that I've had. One of them, the FBI crashed through my mom's house looking for me.
Wow.
And I beat this girl so bad that I broke her eye socket in her jaw. But I broke my hand on her face. I was really hurt.
How old were you?
What creep was that? I had sideburns.
Oh, this is when creep was? No, not sideburns.
My sideburns was here. Yes. My sideburns was full of fat. Yes.
Okay.
They was like, there go T-Boz running after her. It was a mess. But, you know, I lived, I learned, and I grew from all my experiences, and it made me the woman I am today. And that's why I explained where my anger and everything came from.
Outside of your sickle cell, what would you say your biggest hurdle in life was? A challenge so far to today? What was the hardest thing for T-Bob outside of sickle cell?
Outside of sickle? TLC, they be driving me crazy. Absolutely bonkers.
Really?
It is hard to be in a girl group. Very hard. And not break up too? And three personalities? And I'm not a girl's type of girl. I hang with guys. So that was very challenging for me.
With the chicks?
What? Yes, I love them. Don't get me wrong, sisters, but just like a family,
right?
You have your good and your bad. And it is absolutely hard to be cool with chicks all the time. Yes, it is.
Already.
That was challenging.
T-Boz is here. How did the, was everybody happy because all these people chipped in for this album? And then there was a date, and then there wasn't a date, and then there was a date, and then people started to talk crazy.
They should have never came out with a date and then moved it. It should have just never been a date because just, you know, scheduling with producers and writers and just getting everything together was really hard. And then we went on tour.
Mm.
And so Nelly and New Kids on the Block, we did an arena tour.
Mm.
And so that postponed it as well. So the date just really screwed everything up. I think that was a big mistake. But yes, finally, they liked the album. It went number one in London, Japan, and here.
Nice.
Independently. So it was successful, thank God. And yes, I keep hearing that y'all want a second single. I just got off tour again. You can't be doing videos on tour, y'all.
I do them on the bus.
Okay. So no, I know. And then they're gonna be like, oh, that was so cheap. I told you they was broke. That's why they had it. No. And then they kept saying, y'all, it was Kickstarter. It was not GoFundMe. I wanna slap all y'all for that.
It was Kickstarter.
If you're gonna try to be funny, at least get it right. Be funny like correctly.
Don't know the difference though.
No, because they stupid. Full-time instead of part-time. We got, like, all these full-time dummies. If y'all could be dumb part-time and give me a little space here with some smartness a little bit of the time, that'll help out.
Okay.
But just to break it down, when you have Kickstarter, you can't touch the money. It goes exactly where it's supposed to go.
Right. It's not like y'all just went out shopping or anything.
Like they try to say I did. But how did the TLC Kickstarter thing turn into T-Boz did this
know.
Or that? You heard that crap?
I did.
Now,
I hear everything. I just don't choose not to report on everything.
Of all things, of me, of all people,
right?
I went and, come on now. And how did it go from TLC? Y'all just left Chili out. Why she didn't do it with me? Like, if you're going to guilt me out, let me, like, if you're going to accuse me of some lies, why did it turn into T-Boz did this girl? Let me tell you.
It was all you.
Yeah, right?
So this book is available now, and you're signing it today.
Yes, I have a, y'all come out if you want to meet me, get the book. We have a Q&A, and I'll sign the book, take a picture with you, and it's at A Rich Auditorium, so that's 1280 Peachtree Street.
Right across the street.
Northeast Atlanta, honey. yes, right across the street and everything. And yeah, we're talking about sickle cell, whatever you want to talk about, and ask me in life or anything you wanted to know about TLC. Chili may come through, so
hey,
maybe there too. We'll see.
Okay.
So yeah, it starts at 7 p.m. to 10.
Starts at 7 to 10, across the street.
Mm-hmm.
What? There's a website they can go to?
AcapellaBooks.com.
Okay, go to AcapellaBooks.com for more information and V-103.com for more
That's right. Or get them at the door. I'll be waiting for you at the
Pull
door.
Up on the T-Box. Right. So you've done the tour. We're going back to Europe sometime early next year.
Yes, I am going.
We're about to do a second single.
Yes.
We got this book.
Yes.
And you got an artist.
And yes, I do, Domine.
Okay.
Hey,
Domine.
Hey.
Hey, y'all.
Domine was over there throwing old.
She has a new single called Daytona. Y'all know, right? I'm gonna hit her after we leave. When she fall out that door, don't say nothing. Now she has a new single named Daytona.
Okay.
And it's on everything. What, Apple Music, Spotify?
All of them.
Huh? All of them. Everything. iTunes. Everything.
All of them. Go get them. Good to see you, beautiful.
Oh, thank you. I'm happy to see you too.
Always good to see T-Boz. I wish you more continued success. I wish
thank you.
Health.
Yes.
I wish you health.
He's like, this heifer sick again.
I wish you. Oh, but tell us really quickly, and I'm way over. I'm
okay.
Way over. But I found it interesting. We talked about this off air.
Mm-hmm.
Because of your sickle cell and things that you had to go through, it's challenge. You're in the public spotlight, and you have these meet and greets. But because, explain that again, because I think people need to understand. That was deep.
Okay, with sickle cell, you have a low immune system, and then a lot of us lose our spleens, in which I did.
Okay.
But God looked out for me. It's going to sound crazy. I grew 2 baby accessory spleens, which I didn't know you could do.
Me either.
Okay, you can. See, God be looking out for me, honey.
Okay.
Anyways, so I can't fight off big diseases, but little ones I can. So when we have meet and greets, all the fans have to wipe down with hand sanitizer before they touch me because I catch everything. But like a crazy person, instead of doing what I was told, my doctor said do the T-Boz bump and just fist pump and don't touch, and, you know, wash off. And I didn't. I was on stage sweating, and I started hugging everybody. It was the last 2 shows, and they got me. Them cooties got me. They got me.
Wow.
I was
you
like,
really
dang.
Could just get sick just for being in close proximity.
If it was a man, I would be married every day. I'm telling you. I catch all the cooties. I catch them all. I'd be just catching, hey, boo, hey, boo, you know.
So, I'm still not talking to you right now.
I'm just saying.
T-Boz, great to see you. A Sick you Life is available now in Amazon and all of that, right?
Uh-huh. Barnes & Noble, anywhere books are sold.
It is TLC and Me Stories from on and off the stage. She's doing a signing today, 7 to 10 across the street.
Mm-hmm.
I love you, sis. Good to see you.
Love you, too. Thank you.
Alrighty. T-Boz in the building.